Relational databases. In this video, we're going to look at our database, one that holds student information and classes information. So we'll have a list of students and a list of classes, and we'll have to combine that data in some way. For the students, we might have information such as a student ID, the student name, and what operating system they're using. And of course, we might have a lot of other information, their address, all sorts of things. For the class, we can have a class ID, a class name, an instructor, and again, all sorts of other information. If we look at the student table itself, we might have a table that looks something like this with the student ID, the name, and the operating system. And student one listed there is Fred Fisher, who uses Windows as an operating system. And student 1002, Ralph Squid, who uses OS 10. And student 1003 and 1004, all of that information about the students. Now with this, if we're trying to refer to one of these records, one of these students, we can't do it by name because we might have two students with the same name. We can't do it by operating system because we'll definitely have students with the same operating system. And that would be true of most information. But if we look at the student ID, that we can make unique. So we always have one key field which is unique that we set up, and that's the purpose of having a student ID. Similar idea with classes. If we have a table here with the class ID, the class name, and the instructor, we might have class 1001, Intro to Computers by Bilby Baer, class 1002, Web Design by Michael Glasser, and then class 1003 and class 1004, Database Design and User Interfaces by Bill Gates and Steve Jobs. Again, you could have class names that are the same. One instructor might teach more than one class, or you might have instructors with the same name. But if we look at the class ID, that we can make unique, and so we know that is unique. If we look at those two tables, and we want to be able to relate the information between them, one way that we can do that is just focus just on those unique pieces of information. We're not removing the rest of the information from the table, but just to simplify things, we're just referring to those records by their ID. And when we do that, and we want to connect those, make connections between tables, we can go ahead and have a table that connects the two that has the student ID and the class ID. What I mean by this is if I have student 1, who is taking three classes, class 1001, 1002, and 1003, I can create in that middle table three records that connect those. And I could do the same thing for student 1002. He's taking two classes, and they're listed there. Student 1003 with the four classes, student 1004. And you can go ahead and add as many students as you want, and every time a student enrolls in a class, they have a new record put into that middle table right there, which goes ahead and lets you know which student is in which class. This can become fairly complex. Right here, we have simply four classes and four students. If I had 100 students and 100 classes, just imagine how confusing this table can be, but this is a simplified look. One advantage that this gives us, not only can we look at a student and figure out what classes they're in, if I look at class 1 using the exact same data, I could figure out that there are three students, and it's students 1001, 1002, and 1003. I could do the same thing with class 1002, 1003, and 1004. I know exactly what student is in each class. If we go ahead and take a look at our initial tables, the student table and the class table with their information, we can go ahead and add another table in between them and maybe call it enrollments. This is the table where we would have the student ID, the class ID. We can also have more information. This is enough information to let us know what students are in what class, or when looking at a class, what students are in that class. We also might want to have grade information or other information, so it's not just tying those two together, it could be giving us key information that we need. With this table, the student ID would be tied to the student ID in enrollments, and in the classes table, the class ID would be tied to the class ID in enrollments. We would have one student ID in the student table, but in the enrollments, we could have that ID showing up many times. Same idea with the classes table. I have one time that class ID, it is unique. In the enrollments table, it could show up many times. What we don't have is a unique identification for that enrollment. So we really should add that. So I will go ahead and add the enrollment ID. And what this allows us to do is have a student ID that is always unique for that table. It doesn't have to be unique in other tables, but every table has to have one unique key. and we have that in classes, the class ID, and now we just also have that in the enrollment ID. You can have far more than three tables. You could have hundreds of tables, each table with hundreds of records, each record with hundreds of fields, and you could actually have a whole lot of data in here, but this just gives an overview on how does all of that data come together and work together in a relational database.